Okay, so let us discuss about the embedded C program to turn on and turn off the LEDs with respect to some predefined delay. So in the last video, actually, we just observed what the delay that we achieved with the prescaler to be defined to be 60,000. So we shall actually go through that one. Okay, so first of all, actually, this is the header file that you have, which is basic thing. So define prescaler 60,000. So 60,000 value, that I'm just defining it prescaler. So wherever actual prescaler word comes, which means that that value, that prescaler word means it is 60,000. So I'm defining two functions. One is the PLL. Of course, we know actually the PLL is used to configure certain registers. In that function, actually, we are going to use certain registers to activate the PL, to connect the PLL, then to set the M value, to set the P value. So of course we have discussed all these things, prescaler value and the PLL multiplier value and the PLL divider value. PLL multiplier value, what we call it as M, and PLL divider value, what we call it as the P. So those all things actually we need it, so that is defined in the PLL function. Of course this timer function, that is for the timer registers, TOTC and then TOPR, TOPCR. So those all things we shall go through that functions. So we are defining functions here. Of course, we are passing this delay in this one function. We are going to pass this value, then we are going to configure the timer registers. In these two also, we are going to configure the timer registers. So these two are part of the timers and this is part of the PLL. So let me write it here. So this is PLL and this one is part of the timer. So these two are part of the timer, these two functions. Okay, so next one, main one, int main function. So here we are going to actually select the pin cell 1. So basically this IODR0 what I have written. So why are we doing the pin cell 0? Sorry, pin cell 1. So pin cell 1 is used so that actually what all registers are going to be, so what all functionality that we are going to select here. This is basically GPIOs. So we are going to select GPIOs. So which all pins we are going to select as GPIOs? In this case, it is P0.162, P0.23. P0.162, P0.23. In this case, actually, what do we have here? This is, okay, so we have configured the GPIOs P0.162, P0.23. In this case, IODA00X00FF40s. Here, what we are doing actually, so we are setting this P0.162, P0.23 as output port. Okay, so as output port, we are setting here. So P0.162, P0.23, we are setting these pins as output port pins. That's what we are doing here, right? So IODIR, when you set it as 111, so 0.00FF40s, 0.16, 0.23, we are setting it as output port. Next, we are calling the PLL function. So whenever I actually call this PLL function, it comes here. So in this case, what are we doing here? So basically, actually, we are configuring the PLL con register. So first thing actually what we are doing in this PLL 0 CON. So PLL 0 CON, which means that PLL control register. As I said earlier, PLL, you have PLL 1 and PLL 0. Since we are having the CCLK, the processor clock frequency we are using, so that PLL 0 we are using. So PLL 0 CON means PLL 0 control register. So let me go back to that. Okay, so here what do we have here? Okay, so this is what PLL control register. In this PLL control register, this part and this part, this is PLL enable and PLL connect. So these two should be set to 1. So in order to set these two should be 1, the value that has to be written is, yes, that is the last bit, that is 0x0000. This is the, okay, sorry, this is binary. 0B, okay, so binary 0x0B0000, this 11. So this is 0th bit, and this is PLL enable, and this one is PLL connect. So those two should be 1. This activates a PLL, this connects the PLL, so that you get the desired frequency. So that is done in PLL con. That's what I am writing 0x03. This is hexadecimal digit, okay. So then PLL configuration 0x24. Lastly, what happens actually if I do 24 here? Means this we have discussed. So what happens to your M value? So M is basically sorry, m cell is m minus 1. So what will be the multiplier value for this case? Let me write capital M minus 1 here. So M cell, what did we get there in the last video? So M cell basically here in this case it is 4, but M value for PCLK, that is let me write CCLK. If I just go into the formula, just observe this one. Let me repeat this one. See here. So what do we have here? This says M is equal to CCLK divided by FOAC. CCLK, how much it was taken? CCLK, it was taken to be 60 megahertz. So 60 megahertz, and what was FOAC? 12 megahertz, isn't it? So basically, how much you get M to be? This will give M is equal to 5. So that M cell becomes M minus 1. What you get is 5 minus 1 is 4. Similarly, you can just observe P here, CCLK, FCCO. We just did the calculation. You can just go back to the video and see that calculation. So based on this calculation, how much we got it? We got P to be equal to 2. Okay. So P to be equal to 2. So whenever we get P is equal to 2. So this will actually, that is what actually we are doing here. Okay. So sorry, in this one. So here, what are we selecting here? So basically what we are selecting, this gives me for that case M is equal to 5 here. That's what we achieved, and so that M cell becomes 5 minus 1, 4, and P value what we get is 2. So how we get this value, you can just observe the previous videos and you get to have the value of M cell and P value. So this is what you are putting here, M cell and the P. That is what you are putting here. Okay, so this basically, this is PLL multiplier and this one is divider value. Now finally you have this PLL feed 0xAA and the PLL 0 feed 0x55. So why should this be there? See, PLL 0 feed and PLL 0 feed, this is A and the 55, as I said earlier, these are the feed sequences that you have to give. See, no matter actually what you give PLL con and the PLL configuration, these values will not be taken, will not at all be considered if you don't give this A and the 55 feed sequence. That is a sequence, it's like a key. It's like key to unlock the PLL con and PLL configuration. So let me write it here. It's a key. It's a key to unlock. Key to unlock. Okay. So it is key to unlock this con and configuration. Okay. So that is what you have it here. Now last one, VPBDEAV 0x01. Why do we have 0x01? In the previous video you can just see that whenever you feed this 0x01, if I go back and just show it here in the first one, what is this 0x01? When you feed this one, this PCLK is same as CCLK. So because this peripheral clock goes to the timer here. Okay, and that is what actually 60 megahertz you get, because CCLK you got 60 megahertz, but processor clock you are not connecting to the peripheral devices. This APP clock only you are connecting that one. So APP clock, now it is set to the processor clock, that is 60 megahertz. That's what, in order to APP bus clock is same as the processor clock, in order to achieve that one, 01 you have to give. So of course 0th and 1 bit, if you have to give 01, means rest all bits, if you make it 0, it becomes 0x03. That is what it becomes, 0x01. Okay, so that is what it has been written here. VPBDIV is equal to, okay, APBD, VPBDIV, it's fine. Now you can write VPBDIV is equal to 0x01. Okay, so you can use this VPB also. So VPBDIV is equal to 0x01. Now, so this is with respect to the PLL configuration. Now we will come to the timer configuration. So what do we do with the timer configuration is, this is what timer function, TOPR is equal to prescaler. Now what I am setting this prescaler register. So prescaler register has to be set, isn't it? So the prescaler register, instead of writing 60,000, you can write 60,000 here also, not required to define here, but I have defined that one. So whenever I need to change, I can just change it here. So now TOPR, what is TOPR set here? So TOPR PR is equal to 60,000. Now, so when it is set to 60,000, what do you have? TOTC, TOTCR, and then TOTCR. This is timer counter, this is timer control register. Then you have the last one is this is also TOTCR. This is timer counter, timer control register, timer control register. Okay, so this is timer counter. So how much I'm filling the timer counter initially? This is 32 bit counter, isn't it? Just you can observe here. This is timer counter, TOTC. Okay, so maybe let me write this one. This is same as TOTC. Okay, so this is what you have, TOTCR for timer 0 if you are using. Okay, there are timer 1 also. Pre-scaled register TOPR. Okay, of course, pre-scale counter we are specifically not defining here. That pre-scale counter is always set to 0 only. So that pre-scale counter PC internally you have that one. So pre-scale counter will get incremented to whatever value that is specified in the pre-scaler register. Okay. So this first we are setting this TOTC. TOTC I'm just resetting that one by making entire 32 bits as zeros here. So now TOTCR is equal to 0x01. As I said in the last video, what this does, 0x01. 0x01 basically starts the timer, and what this does, 0x00, this basically stops the timer. Okay, this stops the timer. That's what we discussed here, isn't it? If you just observe here, yeah, so here this is counter enable. Okay, so if I write this bit as 1, then it's starts this are enabled, TOTC and the TOPCR, whereas if this is set to 0, then they are disabled. Okay, so starts the timer means timer is started based on what value you put in TOTC, and then the pre-scale counter what it gets incremented till TOPR. Now, so that's what, to start the timer you give 0x01, to stop the timer you give 0x00. Okay, so this is what you have, but one thing what you have to understand here is that, so that is what initialization, it has not been done here. So let just on initializations has been done. If you just observe here, timer 0_initializations, only this function is called here. Okay, only this function is called here. When this function is called, you just set TOPR is equal to prescaler. So TOPR is equal to prescaler. Now TOPR is equal to 60,000. So it just go back here, while off on, you're keeping in the loops that blinking on and blinking off, it keeps on happening. Now what is IO set 0 is equal to 0x00FF40s. So basically actually you are sending 1 here. So this is all we all know. So 1 to which port pins, 0.16 to 0.23. For those port pins actually we are setting high. Okay, we are setting high. This is used for setting those port pins, so you are making those port pins as output port. But here you are actually setting high value on those port pins. Okay, so you are actually making these port pins as output port. Here you are making setting high value on those port pins, means you are sending one, better way if you have to say like that way, you are sending one on those port pins, that is 16 to 23. When you send once, you are, this is the important thing, that you are calling the delay function here. Okay, so let me actually, yeah, so here I am actually calling the delay function. In the earlier case actually what we did, if you have to blink on and blink off the LEDs, there we just use the delay function, isn't it, software delay. So that delay function we just use it, and then there was a specific amount of delay. But here we are actually sending this value. So I am calling delay function, but with this comes here unsigned long int ms. So this ff, this value will be assigned, will be passed onto this parameter. Okay, so this value comes here, then what will be assigned here? So this value void delay, now what do we get here? This value get it here, 0x60ff. When that comes here, okay, why I have chosen particularly ff here? You know that actually in the last video we discussed, if we give ff here, how much delay we get here? This is basically 255 multiplied by that 1 by 60 megahertz multiplied by 60,000. That's what we get, isn't it? So for that case, actually, what was the amount of delay that we got? 0.255 seconds, isn't it? So 0.255 seconds, you get it here. Let me write neatly. So 0.255 seconds. So that is what delay you are getting here. So of course, so this value is passed on here. When this value is passed on, it comes here. Now TO TC are just actually assigning 0. So it starts counting from 0 value. Then TO TC start the timer. When you start the timer, while TO TC less than or equal to millisecond. So what is this millisecond? Where do you get this millisecond? That millisecond is this one, that is FF value. So TO TC less than or equal to millisecond means TO TC till from 00000 to 0060 FF. So this value from all 8 zeros to what value it will get incremented? 0x000000 FF. Till this value it keeps on incrementing. Okay. Till this value it keeps on incrementing. And what is the amount of delay that you have it? See, that you have to understand here. So here you are setting, first you have set the your past high value, that is logic 1. When you pass the logic value 1, all the LEDs are turned on, then you are specifying delay. When this delay is specified, what is the amount of delay that you get it here? This FF comes here, this F millisecond, TOTC less than or equal to millisecond. So TOTC less than or equal to 0x000000FF. So till this value, it keeps on incrementing, means from 0 to FF. Till that value, what you do? You provide the delay. So how much amount of delay that you get? That amount of delay that you get is 0.255 seconds. Okay. How we get this one? This we have observed in the last video. So 0.255 seconds, till that one you are setting high. After that one, again you are clearing, means you are setting your 0. Otherwise, you are clearing those values, or you better way to say it, you are setting low value on those port pins, that is you have 0.016 to 0.023. Again, you are giving the delay of, you are calling this value. Again, it comes here. So this comes here, this comes here. Again, you are resetting the counter. Then TOTC 0x01, start the timer. TOTC less than or equal to milliseconds. You see, this is important that you have put this semicolon. Okay. Till that value, actually you be in that loop only. This condition is satisfied, so be in that loop only, and then keep on incrementing the counter. After actually 0.25 seconds, when TOTC actually goes beyond the 0.25 seconds, it exits this loop. Means TOTC doesn't go beyond 0.25 second. 0.25 second is basically the time that you get, but TOTC goes beyond FF. That is FF means what do you get next value? That is 1100, isn't it? So what you get is 0x000000100. So when you get this value, then it comes out of this loop, then you are stopping the timer. You are stopping the timer again. So when you are stopping the timer again, this actually so that your value blinking off. Blinking off is done for 0.25 second. Again, it since while of 1 you are kept in the loop here. So your blinking on is for 0.25 second and blinking off is for 0.25 seconds. So these two things keep on happening. So your blinking on and blinking off will be done for 0.25 seconds, 0.25 seconds. So it keeps on happening all the time as you kept in the while loop. So this is how we achieve the delay by using a dedicated hardware, that is timer. Okay. So hope you got this point. Okay. Thank you.